Okay, I just wanted to show you a little thing about Python that you might find useful to know when you're trying to test programs and stuff. So I have made a trio of files. I have a file called Ford, which is just has a couple of functions that print some quotes. I have a file called Arthur, which prints some other quotes, and then I have a file called dialog, which imports the Ford and Arthur files and then alternates between quips from Arthur and quips from Ford. So here I am on Elvis, our Unix machine. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do what you probably usually do, which is I'm going to run Python 3 on dialog.py. And you'll see we get this cute little dialogue from Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Okay, so that's great. But suppose you're busy working on this multi-file project or even a single file project, and you want to test out Quip 1. Okay, well, one way you could test out Quip 1 is you could down here, you could write, all right, let me just run Quip 1. Or you could edit, you know, if I do it like that, then when I import Ford, I think it'll actually run that just as it's being imported. So for example, now if I run dialog.py, the first thing that's going to happen, maybe we'll make it, yeah, we'll leave it like that. Then if I run this, it starts out by saying we're safe, and then it does my little dialogue, right? Because when it imported, it printed the anything that's left indented gets run, right? So it just printed quip one. Okay, but you know, maybe you don't want to do that. You want to test out just quip one, and then run your dialog function. Well, one thing you can do is down at the bottom of this Ford code, I actually have this if underscore underscore name underscore underscore equals equals main, right? And what that means is if you ran this file, so this file is the main file, then do these two things, quip one, then quip two. Maybe we'll just make it quip one so you can see it. I'm just doing that. So if, for example, I say Python 3 and then Ford.py, because I'm running Ford.py, it's going to say, ooh, the name is main, and it's going to run just quip one. So I can check it, right? But notice that if I run Python 3 on dialog.py, that part gets ignored, right? So it's just doing what this says, and it's ignoring, even though this is outdented, it's saying, oh, well, that's only if this is the main, right? And so that's very useful, and you can use that to test, like, let's suppose I just wanted to test a function in my code. Very useful. And the other thing that you might not know about is this thing called shebang. Here we go. At the very top of my dialog code, I actually have a function. Sorry, I have something that looks like a comment, and it is a comment, but if I'm running on a Unix machine, this is also something that I can actually use to get this started as a Python 3 command without without having to prefix it with Python 3. So if I do an ls-l of dialog.py, you will see that right now it's not actually executable. But if I do a change mod of dialog.py and I do another ls-l, now it is executable. You can see it right here, right? And so I've turned it into an executable, and when you try to execute a file from the command line, the first thing it tries to do is run whatever command is specified in this hash bang line, right? The shebang line. And so now I can say something like dot slash dialog dot py, and it runs this function using Python 3. So there's no difference between Python 3. Oops, let me update here. Saying Python 3 dialog dot py, and just saying dot slash dialog dot py, assuming that my version of Python 3 that I'm running for the Python 3 is actually user bin Python 3. So a couple of things going on here. The main one that I wanted to show you about was this if name equals equals main, because sometimes you can, test much smaller pieces of your code and it's very useful and you can just leave it in there for later. But also I thought you might like to see this shebang thing, because one of the things that we that I get you to do in the homework is to make sure that the tester file is executable. And the reason that I do that is because when I actually run the tester code, it just executes it. I hadn't made a big deal about this because the shebang may not work on whatever machine you're using, but for sure it works on Elvis. So there you go. Hope this was helpful.